Bishop Rawsthorne Church of England Language College, a high school in Croston, United Kingdom, housing students from year 7 through year 11, was our first stop. This means the students in this high school ranged in age from 11 years old at the beginning of their first year through 16 years old at the end of their last year. Our visit to this school taught me, in an overwhelming way, that passion is important in education. We discussed in class how teachers are sometimes the worst people to publicize for schools because they are always finding flaws, talking badly about students, and even talking badly about other staff. However, I didn't see any of that at Bishop Rawsthorne. The head teacher, Mr. Alan Davies, was so positive about his staff and how they were all positive about their students. Mr. Davies made it a point to state that he believes that every member of the school, both staff and students, deserves the opportunity to progress and show progress. Through his immense passion for educating the future leaders of tomorrow, I found Mr. Davies to be very similar to Dr. Frederick Witham from Yellow Breeches Middle School. They were both proud to show off their staff and all of the success that their schools had achieved. Mr. Davies also made it a point to show us how important student success is. The walls in the hallways and in every classroom were plastered with student work and student achievements. He believes that you need to show and celebrate student work, and every hallway and classroom in the building clearly models this belief. By being given the opportunity to see such immense celebration of student work, this point was driven home. Over the past 3 years at Lebanon Valley, I learned that a plain classroom is dull and an unmotivating work environment, and after seeing the students' work hanging on bulletin boards and walls in both classrooms and hallways, I plan to create new ways to acknowledge and display their effort and work that my students put forth in the classroom. The vast amount of decoration of student work and informational posters garnished on the walls also provided me with an example of Howard Gardner's multiple intelligences. The students who need that extra visual to help them make connections would definitely have the resources to do that at this school. The bodily kinesthetic learners were also able to receive tailored instruction at Bishop Rawsthorne. Many of the lessons taught involved group work and getting up to move around the room to stations or to gather data by completing tasks. What may seem like minor adjustments to lesson plan design can cause major improvements with student learning and success. Along with seeing how teachers tailor instruction to meet the learning styles of all students, I learned what it's like to have the entirety of a school staff work to accommodate all students. The staff work to tailor instruction and provide accommodations to help students of various ability levels. A goal of this school was to keep students with special educational needs in the classroom as much as possible throughout the school day. Students were placed in regular classrooms and given as many accommodations as they needed to be successful there. Mirrors were installed in the stairwells to help a student with brittle bone disease see around corners and avoid getting injured. To help another student see the material in class, he is supplied with a laptop and camera to take pictures and enlarge the information on the board. He is also supplied with large print texts while reading. A third example is the installation and use of Zoom Link, which is a microphone system that amplifies what the teacher is saying so the student can hear it more clearly. Although some of these accommodations involve acquiring new equipment, the staff at Bishop Rawsthorne believes in mainly adapting their original equipment rather than buying new things. A number of pieces of equipment for students with special educational needs can be adapted from original materials rather than spending more money to acquire something that the school may already partially have. As a future special educator, seeing all the accommodations available to students who need them was truly impressive and inspiring. Adapting existing materials and equipment is such a unique idea that does not seem to be prominent in the United States, but it is something that I think even I can attempt in order to help my students. Accommodations in the classrooms at Bishop Rawsthorne also include an aide. Throughout the different educational departments, there is a number of learning and teaching assistants, known as teacher's aides in the United States, provided to help the students. These aides work both with the students who are labeled with special educational needs and those who aren't. Unlike many classrooms in the United States, where most aides only work with the students who have disabilities, these aides provide an opportunity for students with disabilities to see themselves as equals with their classmates. The students aren't branded as having a disability because they have an aide who only works with them, which allows the students with disabilities to have a little more self-confidence. Again, as a future special educator, this is another novel idea. We often learn about labeling students and how that isn't something we want to do when we diagnose them with a disability. But special educators' actions in the classroom do not support that mentality. If we would work to help everyone in the classroom rather than only the student who needs the help, the student might feel more comfortable among his or her peers and have higher self-esteem. Ultimately, Bishop Rossthorne both taught me new concepts to take back to my own classrooms in the United States, such as adapting existing materials for students with disabilities, and reinforced concepts that I had already learned the basics of in classes both at Edge Hill and Lebanon Valley, such as celebrating and displaying student work and having a positive, supportive environment for both staff and students. But at the end of the day, it's passion that keeps schools like Bishop Rossthorne alive with students and success.